Wouldn't it be awesome if you can send customized concert tickets with their name and their image? That is possible. Or maybe start an email campaign which each of the individuals receives an email with a customized image with their company name, their logo, and all of that. That is possible with this automation. What I'm going to show you is how to connect SwitchBoard so you don't think it's complicated, because on this video, I'm going to show you how easy it actually is. For this automation, I'm going to use Pabbly Connect, which has a really great free version that you can actually use also. So let me show you what the deal is with SwitchBoard Canvas and how to actually set it up. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. What's up, everyone? My name is George and this is SaaS Master. This is the deal that I'm talking about, and it starts off at $69 for the lifetime deal. And the whole idea of this is to create a base template of an image with text that can be customized with variables using an automation system. Like I mentioned before, don't get worried. I'm going to show you how to set it up. Now, let me show you really quickly what the $69 deal gets you, and it's over here on the plans. So you get up to 5,000 API calls per month. So that means that you can create 5,000 of these images in case it's one variable. If it's more variables, well, you gotta deduct those from the API calls. You can create 2 image sizes per call. I mean, don't worry about that limit, because you can replicate this on the automation that I'm going to show you to kind of evade that, because you can create another API call and create more variables of the image size. 25 images per batch, and batch creates 25 rows from Airtable. So if you are using Airtable, it can create up to 25 rows. If you have 100 rows, well, it's only going to create 25 of those, okay? So if you need more limits, you can jump into license tier 2 or license tier 3. And if you guys want to grab that deal, the link will be provided in the description, which helps me out with a small commission. Okay, so let me show you SwitchBoard Canvas. It's super easy to set up. It's not complicated at all. The thing that's going to take you the most time is actually creating a nice template to use. But once you create it, you create the automation and you're good to go. Everything is automated. So the template library is this one right here. And I think this is one of the biggest weak points of SwitchBoard Canvas, is that they have not enough templates. Basically, there's 11 templates, which is not enough. They need to dedicate some time to create some really nice templates so we can use these, well, more easily. But again, you can use any graphic designer software and import your image so you can create your templates. I am going to use any one of these. Let me choose one of these because I want to show you how easy this is. I'll select this one. Yes, I'll use that. It's going to open up the canvas so I can work. You can open up the design on Canva if you have an account there. All you have to do is sign in, and you can work from there, and it'll import that image. In this case, I'm not logged in and I don't use Canva. I use Crello and I use Glorify. I use other image softwares. But in this case, we are not going to go fancy because I don't want this video to take a long time. But the concept, you're gonna get it really easily, okay? So each one of these elements that is right here has an API name, which we're gonna use those a bit in our automation. If I add another image, another text, or a rectangle, that's what they have available right now, it's gonna add one of these API names, which we can later use to customize our automation. So in this case, this piece of text, we can customize it. So if this were to be a company name, and I'll just name this company name, okay? And this right here, I'm actually going to change the API name also, company, so I can locate it easily. Over here, I'm gonna name this job title, because that's a form that I've created, and I'll just put CEO. Obviously, these are gonna be replaced with the automation. And what else did I add on my form? So this is the form that I'm going to use, the name, okay? So in this case, I am going to add another piece of text. Here we go. And I'm gonna name this name, and I'll just say name for this. It's gonna be a big piece of text. And I didn't add an image uploader, but you'll get the idea. Okay, so we have 3 elements that are gonna be switched with the automation that I create. What is this going to mean for you? Let's just say that you are selling concert tickets. Well, we want these variables to be changed. We want their name and the company name and their job title. And that's gonna be added to the template. Obviously, this is not a nice template. You create a really nice one, a really nice looking badge, and it's gonna automatically update the variables with the name, whatever you add to it, okay? That's the concept of this. If you're gonna use this for email marketing, also you can switch up the variables so it works for that, okay? So another weak point that I find on SwitchBoard is the lack of elements. So right now we can only add image, text, and rectangles. So it's not a complete image designer. I would recommend design on Canva, Crello, Glorify, something really nice, and then just add the variables here, which is going to be the image and the text. All the rest, I would create it on an image editor, which is basically made for that, okay? This is made for the automation, the API calls, okay? So once you have a nice looking template, you align the things that you are going to place them. In this case, I'll put it right here. And the next thing I want to show you is the automation. Really quickly, you can upload your own text. So font, I mean. So for example, I'm using the font family over here, which is these that they have available, but I can upload my own font, which is really important because, well, most of us don't like the fonts that come in stock, so you can add your own. And these are the settings that we have right here. Background color, highlighted color, background height, that's some kind of things. I mean, nothing really fancy, nothing that I would really be hyped about, okay? So let's just say that I have my image ready, my template, super cool. Okay, and I'm gonna get started with my automation. So this is what I'm going to use. It's called Pabbly Connect, and it's similar to Zapier. If you're gonna use that, you can also use Zapier again, but I'm going to show you how to do it on Pabbly Connect because, well, this is what I use for automation. They have a really nice free plan in case you guys wanna use that or if you wanna go to the paid plan. Okay, so what I've done to get started is I've added a webhook. This is not connected to SwitchBoard already. This is just the step before it. This is called the trigger. What is a trigger? Well, a trigger is something you pull for something to happen, okay? So we are going to use this information, this trigger, to create our customized image from SwitchBoard. In this case, I've connected a job form that I created really quickly. So I created a job form and I connected it via webhook, okay? You can use any form builder that has webhook. You can use, I don't know, if someone signs up to WordPress, to your site, and you send that information to Pabbly Connect, well, it's gonna use that information to create our next step, okay? So this is the information that I have from the form, and now comes the fun part, connecting SwitchBoard, okay? So let's search for SwitchBoard. Here it is, SwitchBoard Canvas. I am going to select it. I'm going to create an image. That's the action event that I'm going to use. I'm going to connect. And in this case, I have previously connected. If you haven't connected, all you have to do is, let me go back here. Templates. Okay, it's saved, no worry. I'm going to view your API key. That's the only piece of content you're gonna need for Pabbly Connect to connect to SwitchBoard, okay? So hypothetically saying, you already connected your API, and you're doing this, okay? It's connecting, it's reading the information from SwitchBoard. And just like that, you are connected. We're gonna be able to view our templates, and now we're gonna fill in the data that we need. It's gonna ask us for the width and height that we need. In this case, it's gonna depend on the size that you actually need for your email marketing campaign, for your concert ticket, for your donation, thank you, for your certificate, whatever you wanna use this for. But in this case, I'll use 1080p by 1080p. So I'm gonna make it squared, okay? And in this case, I'm not gonna move around the panel. The image, I didn't create a field on my form for the image, but if I did have one, well, we can replace the image with our own. Shadow, we're not gonna work with that. The job title, we are gonna grab it from our variables from our form, okay? So in this case, let's locate that variable right here, job title. And for the name, we're gonna locate again the name. Here it is, we're gonna add the first name. Here we go, and the company, we also have a variable on our form. Here we go, SaaS Master, there we go. So now it's connected, and everyone that fills out this form with the specific variables that they select, it's gonna update automatically and create an image. So right now, if I run this test, let's go for it, it's gonna give us an image link. Here we go. Here's the image link right here that we're going to use. Let me go ahead and open this up on my browser. And there it is, it updated, Jorge, SaaS Master, CEO. Now that's just for my test, okay? Now this is ready. Let's go ahead and save this, okay? And the automation is on. We're gonna go into history. In this case, we can further automate this, and I'll show you some quick tips on that in a bit. I wanna give you a test. So let me refresh. Nothing's happening here, no task history. I'm gonna fill out this form with different data, and I'm gonna show you the results, okay? So again, we're gonna say Johnny Cage from the company Mortal Kombat, and this guy is on the accounting job title, and we'll just say test at test.com because we're not actually using that variable. So I'm going to submit it. There we go, it's been submitted. It should be working now, sending that information via Pabbly Connect to SwitchBoard and create that image for us. So in our history right here, let's go ahead and refresh it. Here we go, it just worked. So it created that variable. Here's the task history just to show you what's going on. And this is the result we just got. Let me go ahead and copy this. Let me show you what results we got. Here it is, Johnny, and I didn't add the last name, but if we add it there, from Mortal Kombat, and he's in the accounting job title, okay? So you can see how that updated. You could do that with really nice looking templates to create your automations. Now, what can you do with that? Okay, what do I do with that link? Well, let's go back into the automation really quickly. In this case, we can further automate this. We can add delays in case we don't want to send this really quickly. We can add filters also. So if I want to add a delay and say, hey, you know what? After delay 4 minutes, and I'll just say after 5 minutes, let's go ahead and save this. Again, let's go ahead and save it. Successful. Now we can further automate this, connecting it to something else or sending an email from here. If I connected to Gmail, we can send an email straight from here, send an email, and we can add that link as the image, and it's gonna send the image. Or we can connect to, for example, SendinBlue, which is another automation marketing, email marketing system, and we can create that and send over the template with that variable, so it sends the image. I mean, the options are limitless. You can create your automations really complex or really simple, depending on what you need. But basically, you get the overall overview of what SwitchBoard Canvas can do. Now, it's gonna depend on you and your creativity to decide what you're gonna do with those automations. But just like you saw there, it's easy to create the templates, add the variables, connect on Pabbly Connect or Zapier or Integromat or whatever you want to use for the automation, and further automate it to create your task automated. So like I mentioned before, the most time-consuming part of all is creating that nice-looking template. There, well, the next thing that comes up is creating the automation. And once that's created, well, you're good to go. It's automated. You don't need to worry about it. It's gonna do it automatically. Every time you make a sale, every time that someone fills out a form, every time that someone signs up on your, your SaaS, your WordPress site, your membership site, or whatever, it's gonna automatically create those images for you. Well, there it is. That is SwitchBoard Canvas. If you guys wanna grab that lifetime deal, that link will be provided in the description. It provides me a small commission, which helps me out to make these videos for you guys. Well, I thank you all for watching. My name's George, and this is SaaS Master. I'll see you guys later.